Welcome to the Parker Daniels Show, where amazing stories are shared and hope is given.
Welcome, everybody, to the Parker / Daniels Show. My name is Nicole, the founder of Rose Color Glasses, and I'd like to introduce the fabulous leader of the pack. Say what's up, Anthony.
What's up, Anthony? Nicole, how you doing today?
I'm great. So what do we have on the agenda today?
Well, today we have, well, I sound like a game show host. Today we have Shane. Shane is a 42-year-old native of Pennsylvania who lost his sight due to retinitis pigmentosa around 5 or 6 years old. Now, he's adjusting to a whole new life of adapting to being blind. Now, I want to let y'all know for the record, Shane has been working since 1995, and he's going to explain to us what he does. He also still finds time to do something he loves so dearly, and I won't tell y'all what that is. Y'all have to stay tuned to the video. So, with that being said, without further delay, Nicole, introduce our guest, Shane.
Hi, Shane. How are you doing this afternoon?
Good, Nicole. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. So why don't you tell us a little bit about how you are starting to lose your vision?
Well, I have an eye disease called retinitis pigmentosa. And basically, with that eye disease, you slowly lose your eyesight. Some people it's slow, for some people it's fast. For me, it's been a slow progressive loss. And the first thing to kind of, oh, sorry.
No, I was disagreeing.
Oh, the first thing you kind of lose is like your night vision, and then you lose your peripheral, which you kind of get tunnel vision. And after a while, the eyesight you have at the end of the tunnel, you kind of start losing that. So okay. That's where I'm at now, where I'm losing my eyesight at the end of the tunnel. Basically, all I have now is light perception.
Okay. So what are some of the challenges that you see as from being a sighted person and now being a person who is visually impaired and or blind?
Well, my first challenge was accepting my loss of eyesight. I hated the world for a while. And that wasn't working. So I decided I need to get happy to move on with my life. And that's exactly what I did. I accepted my loss of eyesight. And now I'm moving on. I'm just a regular guy and enjoying life.
So when we were talking off camera, you were telling me about you being employed. Can you tell our viewers out there what you do and what you have done have inspired your employers to do something totally that you wouldn't think the employers would do?
Well, I've been working at a meat plant since 1995. And, you know, they threw with me as I lost my eyesight slowly. And over the years, they've just kept accommodating me and finding ways for me to work. And, you know, I'm thankful they did that for me.
So how many years have you been working there so far? So since 1995, and you're still currently working to 2019?
Yep, I'm still working there today. I work today, actually.
Oh, my goodness. I am so amazed at you. However, you've been telling me some other things that you do on the side. Let's talk about your YouTube channel.
Well, after accepting my loss of eyesight, I decided to start a YouTube channel called See It My Way. I just want everybody to see that the loss of your eyesight does not mean the loss of your world. So I want you to see it my way. So in my channel, I just do things I enjoy, talk about my loss of eyesight, do some fun challenges, just all kinds of interesting things. And I also share my hobby of metal detecting and as the blind treasure hunter.
All right, tell us a little bit about your blind treasure hunting. Tell us some of the things that you found and how cool it is that as a blind person, you can still do some of the things that you love.
Well, I metal detected when I was able to see, and it was a lot easier back then. And I decided I'm not going to lose something I'm passionate about. So I just found ways to keep on metal detecting. So sometimes, like, if I'm out in a field or somewhere metal detecting, I'm by myself and I get lost, I just FaceTime my wife, I turn the camera around, and I say, where am I? You know, I ask for her help through the phone. And I love technology for that reason also.
So I heard that you found a coin on one of your treasure hunts from 1700s?
Yes, actually I found a couple. My first coin I found from the 1700s was a 1773 real, which is a Spanish coin.
And
when I first found it, I had no idea what it was, because I knew what quarters felt like, I knew what nickels felt like, I knew what dimes felt like, I knew what pennies felt like. So I found this, and I had no idea what it was. So when my wife finally came and picked me up, and she told me the date on it, I thought she was joking with me. But it was actually a coin from 1773.
Have you had that coin appraised yet?
Yeah, it's actually worth about $40.
Oh, wow. So, in closing, because I want you to, you know, once again, let us know your link. And guys, for you guys out there, we're going to put his link in the comment
description.
In the description box, so that you guys can go and check out his channel, The Blind Treasure Hunter, and also See It My Way. So go ahead and plug your YouTube site again, please.
It's See It My Way with the number one. And
okay. Go ahead.
Oh, that's what the channel is. It's See It My Way One.
Okay. So See It Your Way One. And yes. If there's any encouraging words that you can leave out for our viewers out there, what would it be?
I would say, keep happy, accept your loss of eyesight, and keep moving on. Just live a happy life.
All right. So, Anthony, you want to take us out of here?
Well, I want to say that I enjoyed the interview. I enjoyed sitting back for a change and let my co-host do what she does, and she did a wonderful job. Shane, definitely, one more time, plug the channel.
See It My Way One, as in the number one. And thank you, Anthony and Nicole. This was really awesome.
Thank you.
And y'all go ahead and support them. I mean, for real. You know, there's no hate over here. We love, you know, to basically give love back to those who are definitely doing some things. So with that being said, I don't want to give a long speech, because I do have a lot of wind in me right now, because I didn't say too much in the beginning. To the subscribers, definitely subscribe to the channel. You're going to get very interesting stories like this one here. Hit that notification bell, like, follow, and definitely share, comment, and make this channel, as well as other channels, a success, because we all in this together. So with that being said, Nicole, I'm going to pitch it back to you, and you give your signature, whatever you do, you know.
All right, guys. Just want to say thank you. Thank you, Shane. And as always, thank you for watching the Parker/Daniel Show, where we make changes, no excuses. Bye, guys.
Mwah. Here at the Parker Daniel Show, we want to thank you for always tuning in and watching such amazing stories. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for future videos.